Hello everyone, welcome to this video in which we are going to learn how to interpret our astral experiences or dreams. We must remember that the astral world is the same world of dreams. As we see in lecture number 7 of the self-knowledge course that we are broadcasting every Sunday through this page, astral unfolding is actually a natural process that happens every time our physical body falls asleep. We unfold using the astral body and we have experiences in the fifth dimension of nature. But since we have our consciousness asleep, we tend to unfold unconsciously, that is, without being aware of the moment in which the unfolding occurs and without knowing that we are unfolded, because we are dreaming but we believe that we are in the physical world, even though a dream is completely absurd. As I say, even though we see elephants flying, we don't get to realize that we are actually in the fifth dimension of nature. All those experiences that we live while our physical body is sleeping are what we remember as dreams when we wake up. We have taught in this course that we can consciously unfold to the astral world and that there we can communicate with our inner being, which is our consciousness. We can also investigate there whatever we want, and we can get to know better our own psychology, since when we unfold, we do it towards our own psychology. It is important to know that there is the astral of the planet, of the cosmos, of the universe, and there is our inner astral. Every living being, when sleeping, unfolds to the astral plane. So we as human beings are a microcosm. Just as outside there are seven dimensions, inside us there are those same seven dimensions, since the outside, the macro, is contained within us, within the micro. So you probably have heard about the law of correspondence that says that as within, so without. So it is like this. It is also important to understand that any astral experience, no matter how absurd or incoherent, has some meaning. And therefore, it is very important to make the daily effort to interpret our dreams and our conscious astral experiences, since in them is the information that our inner being needs to show us in relation to our inner world. In our inner world, they show us when recurrences or karmas come. Also, they show us the trials that comes to us and the aspects that we have to work on ourselves, on our own psychology. Also, in the astral world, the advances that we are making in the inner world, we will verify them. In a conscious astral projection, or even in an unconscious astral projection during a dream. Hence, the importance of understanding the need to make the daily effort to remember and interpret our dreams. Now, many people say they don't remember their dreams. Some think that they don't dream, but actually, we all really have astral experiences on a daily basis. So what should we do to remember our astral experiences? Well, two things. The first one is that we have to start making an effort for living consciously, for during the day being aware of ourselves at every moment. If we make the effort of being self-aware during the day, by law of correspondence, we will be aware while dreaming. And the second thing we must do is to practice the dream yoga. And according to dream yoga, What we must do to remember the experiences lived in the astral is that when waking up, we need not to move. Try not to move a single muscle so as not to shake the astral body, and immediately start trying to remember where we were before waking up. What were we doing? If we can't remember, we can help ourselves with the mantra Raum Gaum. We start to chant this mantra mentally, like this, like Raum Gaum, Raum Gaum, until the movie of what we were dreaming begins to arrive. And once we remember it, then we get up and we proceed to take note of the experience, and after writing it down, you can do it in a notepad, or actually there is a very good app in the cell phone that I use that is called Dreams, like this, or you can record it as a voice note so we don't forget it. Then we proceed to interpret. It is important not to leave the interpretation for later, because almost always we receive information for that same day. So we receive alerts about things that are going to happen that day. For example, we are shown that a certain trial is coming to us, and because we didn't interpret experience, we didn't have the chance to pass the trial. So it is very important to organize ourselves so that we have a chance in the morning to remember and interpret our dreams. We must understand that in the astral, most of the time, more than 90% of the time, they speak to us with symbols. And if the person doesn't know what those symbols mean, it will be very difficult to access to the information that the being is indicating for our own spiritual development. We even tend to believe that when we consciously unfold, they are going to tell us things directly. And although they certainly sometimes show us or tell us things literally, most of the time, they show us in a symbolic way, through analogies, through shapes, through numbers. Since the language that is handled internally is a richer language than the inert language that we handle in the physical world. Once we begin to manage the knowledge of the different symbols, and we begin to develop the intuition, which is that ability to understand, to know from the heart without the need of thinking. And we'll see how great wisdom can be contained in a simple or in a single symbol. It is also important that we understand the need for us to learn to interpret our own astral experiences, since the information we receive astrally is usually very personal. And by telling our dreams and our conscious astral experiences to others, we are actually undressing our psychology to others. In addition, a large part of the information that is revealed to us astrally is given to us in a closed book, which means that it is personal information that we shouldn't tell others. And the main reason why we tell our experiences to others is because we ourselves do not know how to interpret them, and we seek others to interpret our experiences for us. And this is one of the reasons why I wanted to make this video, so that we learn to interpret our own dreams and not depend on anyone externally for this, who can mislead or manipulate us psychologically when interpreting our dreams. In addition, it is important to know that no one can interpret our dreams better than ourselves. Since, in addition to what we could say about the dream, experiences have a setting, has a flavor, and have a relationship with aspects of our own psychology and with personal experiences that we have lived that the other person doesn't know. So as we make the effort to interpret our dreams and our conscious astral experiences on a daily basis, we will develop that capacity for interpretation. So now let's see how to interpret astral experiences. Well, the first thing we are going to see are that the astral information sometimes is being shown to us directly. So these are experiences that do not have to be interpreted, since the information that we receive is going to happen just like it is being shown to us, or that they just tell us literally. Actually, it is the least frequent, and of course when it is something very urgent or because it is something in relation to what we are so unaware of that they have to tell us directly in order for us to react. Other times things are shown to us directly so that we begin to overcome skepticism. But as I said, more than 90% of the experiences will be by symbols, since this is the language of awakened beings. It is a living language, and if we aspire to awaken consciousness, we must learn to handle this language. So if the experience is not direct, then we will proceed to interpret it. And for this, it is necessary to know the astral symbology. We are going to start by knowing the meaning of the most common symbols that we find in dreams, in addition to know the meaning of the numbers. For this, along with this video, we are giving away for free a document that is titled Guide for the Interpretation of Astral Experiences or Dreams. In this guide, we are going to find the meaning of the most common symbols that we find in the astral and the meaning of numbers or the Kabbalah that's related to the major arcana of the Hebraic Kabbalah. I actually have it in a PDF format. You can see it here. There you can see it. This is a document I have. It has the meaning of the most common symbols. You see, like the elements, like the phenomena in natural places, buildings, plants, animals, objects, food, colors, vehicles, people, clothing. Well, you can see, you can find there a lot of information. Also the parts of the body, and at the end you're going to find the arcana, the meaning of the numbers from the number 1 to the number 22. And let's see. Okay, and as I said, I have it in a PDF format, but as PDFs cannot be uploaded to Facebook pages yet, I share it as images. But if you want to have it as a PDF, you can write me your email and I will gladly send this document to you. In this guide, you will find, for example, as you saw, the meaning of the animals. So what we are going to find, what does it mean that we dream of a snake or a dog or a cat or a lion? We are also going to find the meaning of the, you see, objects, foods, etc. And the first thing we must do when going to interpret an experience is to look for the meaning of the symbols that have been shown to us. Once we are clear about their meaning, we will proceed to interpret the experience. Astral experiences can be interpreted by similar, by contrary, by analogies of opposites, and by Kabbalah. Let's see each of them. Just give me a second. There you go. By similar, experiences have to do with situations that happen to ourselves in the world of dreams, or situations that one is directly seeing or experiencing in the astral. A recurring dream of many people is to dream of very waters. So if you see here in the guide, water represents our sexual energy. So when we see dirty water in the astral, or that we are bathing in dirty water, is being shown to us that our sexual energy is contaminated. Another example that I could give to illustrate how to interpret experiences that are being shown to us by similar would be that we dream that some lions come to attack us. It is something that in the dream or in the astral experience is happening to us directly. So it is interpreted by similar. If we see in the guide, we see that lions represent the divine love. And in this case, the experience would be shown us that the divine law, which is charging the karma, is going to charge us for a karma. That means that a pain or an illness is coming to us as the result of some mistake we made. It is important to understand that these kind of experiences are shown to us so that we can transcend it. In lecture number 13 in the self-knowledge course, we are going to see what karma is and how to negotiate and pay our karmas to transcend them. So that's how all the experiences in which something is happening to us, or that we see ourselves doing something or making a mistake in a dream, will be analyzed by us. And the experiences are very personal, and we must pay attention to intuition, analyze the experiences both internally and externally. For example, if we have a motorcycle and we dream falling off a motorcycle, internally the motorcycle represents the balance with the sexual potency. So if we have a dream that we are falling from motorcycle, we must be careful during our sexual practice, because probably they are telling us that we are going to have a sexual fall. But we will also have external caution when riding our motorcycle. And the second way to interpret astral experiences is by contrary. This shows us that all the things and all the mistakes that we see in the astral that other people make is because we are making them. Since we have to understand that we unfold towards our own psychology, and everything we see in others in the astral is only a reflection of our own interior. This means that if we see the neighbor in our dream being unfaithful to his wife, they are not talking to us about the neighbor. They are showing us our adulterous eye so that we can study it and we can eliminate it. All the mistakes that we see that others make in the astral, we must take it for ourselves. Let's take an example. Let's say, as we see here, that in the dream world, I go to the house of a friend named Michael. And the house is very messy. And I say, he should tidy up the house because, or since he has free time. Then I wake up and I say, what a strange dream, huh? Yeah, that Michael guy has always been very messy. No, actually, what is being shown to me is that, in that experience, is that my house, which is my inner world, is messy. And one very wisely says that since I have free time, I should make an order. And how do we put order within ourselves? Well, putting ourselves to meditate, to work on ourselves, that is what our being is telling us. Since every time we speak with wisdom in the astral, it is actually the wisdom of the Father that manifests itself in us, giving us a teaching. We also can see in that example, by Kabbalah, the name Michael, which has seven letters. And we see in the guide that the number seven represents the order. So that further reinforces the teaching we receive in that experience. So when we see someone making a mistake, it is for us to work on it, to use it as a mirror. If we work it on ourselves and comes to happen, to really happen externally with that person, for example, that actually we see the neighbor being unfaithful to his wife, because it may happen that it turns out that what we saw in the astral happens physically, it can happen. As we have already worked that on ourselves, we will have an understanding about it that will help us not to fall into criticizing or judging the other person, because we already worked that on ourselves, we already find that, let's say, mistake in ourselves, so we understand, we don't need to judge the person. Let's see, it is very important that we begin to work on our self-sympathy, on our pride, since we always think that it is others who make mistakes. However, we always justify ourselves. But when we start to self-observe and judge ourselves ruthlessly, we will realize that we are the real cause of all our problems. So to make it clear, when something is happening to me directly in the astral, it is an experience by similar, and I must take it for myself, I know that. And when I see that something happens to someone else, or that someone else is making a mistake, that is something that is being shown to me by contrary. Therefore, I must observe that in my psychology and work it. The next way to interpret the astral experiences is by analogies of opposites. This teaches us that many times there are things that mean the opposite. For example, when we eat sweets or candies in a dream, it means that bitterness comes to us. And also, the analogy of opposites is related to reverse psychology. When it is about mistakes that we make that are too obvious, but that we do not fall for reason, in those cases, when they tell us no, it is yes. And when they tell us yes, it is no. It always occurs with situations in which it's only to use common sense. In these experiences, when they tell us, for example, do it by opposite, they would otherwise be saying to do not do it. An example that we could use to clarify this would be the case of a person who is very hooked on drugs and has had many mishaps in his life to this matter, but receives this knowledge, begins to practice, and goes consciously to the astral world and ask his divine mother if he must stop using drugs to advance in his spiritual path. And his divine mother answers, no, that doesn't affect you at all. That doesn't cause you any problem. That is the last thing you have to work on. The person immediately, intuitively feels that he's being told by analogies of opposites, that she is telling him that, yes, that he should stop consuming, that this defect affects him a lot on the spiritual path, and that it's been bringing him many problems, and therefore it is the first thing he has to work on. I explain this because these experiences, even though are not so common, they actually happen. And it is for us to use our common sense in mistakes that we are making and that are very obvious, but that we don't want to correct. When these experiences happen, we feel by intuition that is by analogy of opposites, that actually they are telling us to stop doing this or to do that thing that we don't want to do. The fourth and the last aspect to interpret the astral experiences is by Kabbalah. Here we are going to find the 22 major arcana that are the most basic and the most important. In the interpretation guide that I just showed you, and that I'm sharing along with this video, you will find in the final part the meaning of the numbers from 1 to 22. So let's see how we are going to use the Kabbalah. Well, the first thing is that many times they are going to show us a number directly. For example, that in the astral we saw the number 10. Then that is something that you have to interpret directly. If we go to the guide, we will see that the number 10 represents the recurrence, something that is going to be repeated, something that is coming to happen again. In this case, the situation that has been happening existence after existence now is going to be repeated. Now it's going to happen again. Or also the number 10 can mean the retribution, that would be something that you are going to win for having done some work. We would already determine that according to what we see in the experience and according to our intuition. If, for example, we dream of a number greater than 22, for example, if we dream with the number 461, then what we do in that case is that we add the number, like 4 plus 6 plus 1, and there you're gonna have the number 11. And in the guide you will see that the 11 represents the tamed lion, the law in favor, what would be indicating to us that the divine law is in our favor in the matter that we are requiring or that in which the experience is related. Now, also, intuitively, we could feel that we should add it a little more. Then we would add, like for example, the 11, we would add 1 plus 1, and that is 2. Then they are referring to our partner, since the number 2 represents the couple or a couple process. Even when adding it up like this, we get to complement the meaning of the previous one. Since, for example, if what we ask is if our partner or the person we are with can help us to advance in the inner work, then if we have this dream, the number 11 would be telling us that the law is in favor, that yes. And the number 2 that it is in favor in relation to our couple or in relation to our relationship. So, as I tell you, intuitively, we are going to interpret the responses that we receive. If we add a number, and when adding it, it still gives us an amount greater than 22, we continue adding it until we have a number that is less than 22. Another way that they are going to show us the numbers is with the people we dream of. For example, if I dream with my friend Diego and he comes and tells me that I'm complicated with a payment that I must make, I must interpret the experience as the notice of a karma about to be charged, because Diego has five letters and the arcanum 5 represents the law, the year. So it is important to know that we are going to take the name by which we usually call the person. Since, for example, if my friend is called Michael, but I always call him Mike, I have to take a Mike by Kabbalah. So that would be four letters. Unless I directly in the astral experience have called him Michael. In that case, I'm gonna take him Michael, seven letters. So by Kabbalah, we are also going to take the places, the country names, the streets, the addresses, the time. So if, for example, we dream that we are going to France, then we are going to count the number of letters. France has six letters, and we see in the guide that the number six is related to love or to indecision into something. So there we are already seeing where the experience is going. We will do the same with the addresses. For example, if we go down the 5433 streets, or the, as we say here, the 45689 street, what we are gonna do, we're gonna add those numbers. 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 6 plus 8 plus 9, and that is going to give us, that is 32. Then, as it is a number larger than 22, we are going to add that 3 plus 2, and then it's gonna be 5. But we also can count the number of letters on the street name, and all these give us lots of guide in relation to the information that we are receiving in the astral experience. The same if we have a dream where we see on a specific time. For example, we see that is like this, 12:08. So we add 1 plus 2 plus 0 plus 8, that is 11. And this will help us to know the context of the experience that they are showing us, or the meaning of the answer we are receiving in the form of numbers. Another thing we must take by Kabbalah is the number of things. For example, bread. Bread represents wisdom. And if in a dream you are receiving two breads, you are about to receive some wisdom in relation to your couple, as the number two represents the couple, as I was saying. So at this point, I guess you might be thinking that these are too many things to interpret. But what do we do when in the dream there are many things, therefore there are many aspects to interpret? Well, we must take first the place, the atmosphere. If it is daytime or if it is nighttime, it is actually there telling us something. In the guide, you are going to see what means if it is during the day, if it is during the night, if it is raining, etc. Another thing you should check is where were you? If you were at home, or if you were in the supermarket, or at the airport, or if at another country or another planet. So all this give us a reference to the teaching we are receiving. So if you also know the name of the place, you will take it by kettle. Then what you're going to do, you're going to interpret the symbols and the actions that you see, and you are going to look for the meaning in the guide. And you are also going to take the names of the people you saw in the experience, etc. So you're going to be doing this in order, and you are going to be taking from this the meaning of this, and then you are going to have your interpretation. Let me give you an example of a dream and an interpretation. Let's say that we find ourselves in a dream in France, let's say. So it is six letters, and we know now that six means or love or indecision. So we are walking on the 10th street. So the number 10 is the recurrence. And in that street, we see that a man lets loose some dogs. And the dogs in the guide represents the lust. So those dogs bites a woman in her left leg. If we see in the guide, the left leg represents our will, then there we would clearly see that we are shown that a recurrence is coming in which our lust is going to be excited and it is going to bend our will. Perhaps the will with which we are or we have been doing our internal work. And by this, we will face an indecision, perhaps in relation to love, whether or not to be unfaithful to our partner. So if we interpret it and we are pending to this, when we see that that new co-worker arrives who moves us a lot by lust and with whom we can easily fall into being unfaithful to our partner, we will have pending that. It is a recurrence that is coming to us, and as we will be working on all that lust, all those emotions, thoughts, we are going to transcend that recurrence and we are going to avoid making that mistake and affecting our will and affecting our relationship. Actually, at the beginning, this could be confusing or we may find it hard. But when we start making the effort, we will develop the ability to interpret the symbols with ease. Our being needs us to develop the ability to analyze, to relate, to reflect, which will be very useful in our inner work, in the study of our psychological eyes. When that intuitive ability to relate and reflect develops, those secrets, threats that unite one way of being with another are more easily found during meditation. So that is why this is so important. Now, to finish, what are we going to do if we don't find the meaning of a symbol in the guide? Well, we are going to relate it according to its function, according to its characteristics. What is it for, or how does it act? And we are going to make a relationship. For example, if we dream with a carpet is not in the guide, but we can relate that carpet is something we use to clean our shoes, and shoes are in the guide, and the shoes represents our spiritual path. So what does the carpet means in the astral? Well, a help to clean our spiritual path. Or let's say we dream of a bird, and in the guide the birds are not specifically there, however we see that the birds move in the air, and we see in the guide that the air represents our mind. So when we see birds in the astral, we are seeing eyes or parts of our being related to our mind. But we must bear in mind that for an animal in the astral to represent a part of our being, It has to be an extremely beautiful end. And let's see, you will also take by Kabbalah the amount of them. Like for example, here we have two birds. So we are going to see this is something about relation in relation to my mind, probably some defects. And you are going to take by Kabbalah the number, the word two birds, and you are going to interpret the experience or the symbol. And actually, this has been the information that I wanted to bring you today. I hope it will be useful for you to start interpreting your dream and your astral experiences. If you have any question, you can write it to me and I will be glad to answer you. I take this opportunity also to invite you to the self-knowledge course that we are broadcasting every Sunday through this page. So that has been all for this video. See you next time.